Everybody, welcome to the Off Limits Show. Thanks for joining me on Game Ass tonight. It's Thursday, what is today? November the 6th, 2014. And I am broadcasting to you, as always, from Dallas, Texas, in the heart of Republicanville land. So thanks for listening to the show. Tonight I'm talking about several things. As usual, on Game Ass, we talk about everything and all things gay culture related. So music and topics of conversation, news, whatever. We talk about it here on the show. So thanks for listening. If you don't know about me, you can go to offlimitsshow.com. You can also listen to the show live there if you'd like. And also you can listen to all of my shows on Spreaker.com, Spreaker, Spreaker.com. Also on iTunes, you can subscribe to the Game Ass show or Off Limits show or to the Brain Purge show, all shows under my little umbrella here on iTunes. And I think that's it. So you can find me a lot of places. Excuse me. I muted myself, but I'm having Perrier. It's a little fizzy. Anyway, so thanks for listening to this show. I've been about a week or so since I've done a show, so I've been busy as always, but there's been a lot of things going on in the gay world. One of the things today or yesterday, Rose McGowan had mentioned something about gay men being misogynistic, or she quote said, gay men are as misogynistic as straight men, if not more so. Now, she said that gay men never stand up for female or women's rights, and that even lesbians don't stand up for women's rights. Gay people just care about their own rights, essentially is what she said. And she said gay misogyny is a huge problem. Now, she's been a proponent of gay rights for a very long time, so I don't think she's anti-gay. It has nothing to do with her being homophobic or anything. What it has to do with is her own twisted sense of, I don't know, she basically is putting her big foot in her mouth, because basically that's fucking untrue, especially about me. If you listen to my show for any time now, for the past 4 or 5 years, if you listen to my show, you know that I have said many times that I am a feminist. Even though I'm a man, I am a feminist, and I believe in women's rights, and women should be paid equal to men, and women should have the same rights as men every way, and are just as capable as men in most things. So when I say most things, I mean physically. You know, women generally are less, you know, have less muscle mass. And so in some ways, there's obviously differences between the sexes. They're not going to be able to compete the same way necessarily. Not always. I mean, there's always an exception, but I'm just saying. But every other way, mentally and most things physically, women are equal to men. And I've said that on my show all this time. And my show has always been about equality, not and justice, and justice, not just for gay people, but for people of all races, all religions, creeds, whatever, atheists, atheism, you know, I'm a proponent of that as well. And for gays and lesbians as well. So transgender people, intersex people, asexual people, whatever, I am a proponent of everyone having equality. So it's fucking bullshit. I mean, and of course, I don't have a national platform where I'm talking to. I mean, I do have a national platform, but not where the whole nation's listening to my show, obviously. I have a platform where people listen and, you know, my regulars listen to the show, but I don't have a platform like Oprah Winfrey or someone like that, obviously, where what I think makes a huge difference to the culture. She, however, does. And to say that is just wrong and a broad generalization of gay people. Obviously, there are gay people who don't care about feminism or the rights of women. But there are also numerous of us who do. So I take offense to that, a great offense to that, because I've always been someone who is incredibly, incredibly supportive of rights for women, equality for women. And they have their own struggle as well. And to say that we don't understand that is ridiculous. So fuck you, Rose McGowan. You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. But yeah, it's caused a lot of brouhaha today about that. And she issued an apology. I didn't read it. Yeah, she said something. I know her publicist or someone released some sort of apology about it. And I haven't read it. But whatever she said, the fact is she's dead wrong. So someone else, you know, speaking of rights, standing up for rights, Leah Delaria. If you watch the show Orange is the New Black, she plays, I can't remember her name, but she plays the big butch dyke lesbian on the show on Orange is the New Black. And she's openly gay in real life. She's a lesbian. And she was on the subway in New York City, and some preacher guy was preaching, some black African type dude. It's almost always a black African because Africans are so completely nuts. I mean, I say Africans, I mean people from Africa, about religion. They're like religious zealots. That's why in Africa we have those laws against gays where it's illegal to be gay in some of the countries in Africa. Other countries, you could be beheaded or hung for being gay, or for even, there was a gay wedding or something in Africa. I think it was Africa. I'm pretty sure it was Africa, somewhere in Africa, some country in Africa, where there was a gay wedding and the people who just attended the wedding are being imprisoned. Okay. Just for appearing in a video at a gay wedding. So, you know, it is the Stone Ages there. It really is. And, so a lot of people who come out of there, Africans have that mentality about gays, this horrible, horribly anti-gay mentality, even more so than the Southerners in general. I mean, really bad, really like behead them, kill them all, horrible mentality. So anyway, this guy was, he looked like he was an immigrant or something. And he was on the subway, literally Bible thumping. He had his Bible in his hand, thumping his Bible and saying, you know, gays are evil, going to hell and blah, blah, blah. So she just happened to be on the subway when this guy was proselytizing his message from what he said the Bible said about gay people. And she's there with her black t-shirt, which is Bad Jew on it. Bad Jew on her t-shirt, which is hilarious. She stands up and she actually responds to what this guy was saying. I mean, she was saying essentially that this guy doesn't have the right to say these things and da da da. So I just wanted to play the clip for you so you can hear what she had to say.
Jesus, love you.
You have no right. You have no right.
I have to tell you the truth.
You have absolutely no right. One lady and then a man. No right.
Go right. Jesus, go to another. Ladies and gentlemen, he will deliver you from sin, whatever sin you might be for. Other people believe other things and have every right to believe other things on this planet and in this world. We do not have to be forced fed this man's religious beliefs. Jesus never said for you to do this, ever. Not anywhere in the Bible. Show me anywhere in the Bible where it says it's okay for you to do this. You show me where Jesus told you to do this.
I can show you. What is it?
But don't just read me one quote, sir. You better read me the whole thing. Because about two lines after what you're about to read me, it's going to tell you not to eat pork. It's going to tell you not to wear clothes that are made of mixed fiber. Don't come at me, because I went to Catholic school for 12 years and I know every line.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you.
I want you to stop telling us anything. You do not have the right to do this. You do not have the right to do this. This is mass transportation. And as long as you keep talking, sir, we're the only two left on this train, then so be it. As long as you keep talking, I'll keep talking. You do not have the right. So if you want to press your faith, go onto another train.
Let me tell you this morning.
Don't tell us anything.
That's why America is in so much trouble today.
This is not why America is in trouble.
Sir,
your
reason
America is in trouble. Religious fanatics are the reason America is in trouble.
And he cares about
the
you.
The Tea Party.
I want to tell you, please read your Bible
you
and you will understand. If Sodom and Gomorrah didn't get away,
this is not Sodom and Gomorrah.
Ladies and gentlemen,
even Sodom and Gomorrah is not Sodom and
that sin of homosexuality.
Oh, there we go. Now he calls me a dyke, everybody. Now I've been called a dyke by the Christian.
Okay, so that's it. But anyway, yeah, so basically the gist of it, if you couldn't understand everything we're saying, you know, he's proselytizing and she's telling him why he's wrong and why the Bible quotes or verses he's quoting are incorrect in relation to being gay and how the Bible contradicts itself and how it's hypocritical and blah, blah, blah. And then he goes on about Sodom and Gomorrah and calls her, ultimately he calls her a dyke at the end. And so I just think that's fantastic. And that's something that I would do myself. And if I were confronted with someone like that, I mean, I've had situations like that where I've gone off on people that I've met in public. And it's not something that I am afraid to do. I probably should be afraid because I probably get shot or something, but I do think that, you know, really, it's really great that people do actually stand up for themselves against homophobia. The good thing is that people like her exist, and she's got a great platform being on a hit show on television that